moderate this this event. It will be Asika Singh who will do that. And I was only give an introduction on the team, not telling about the team because that will the moderator do, but I will tell you something about our problem with representation of, not a problem, but our thinking and working around representation of African women. Because we have, before we talk and look to other people, we have also to look on how we do it, or how the African Film Festival does it. So the team representation of Sub-Saharan women, media and art and culture, that will be later explained more and deeply, but we were thinking about that a long time, for more than 25 years. So we had Mariam Kaba. It's only saying that Mariam Kaba, she's an actress, she has a long career in 1989. She had already done a lot of things. She had even got a medal of one of the best African, French African film stars or film actresses in France. So, but we spoke with her and she became a good friend. She came to us and said, "We know, you know, the world is a man's world. The cinema is a man's world. In France, Europe, where she lived and works, she always got second and third rate roles. She always never put in the picture or valid for the work she does." And then she said, most cinema goers, she was, as you can see, in a lot of films and TV series, she was almost daily in television in France. Nobody knew her. She said, and then even when I have a first role, I get sometimes 1/5 of the payment of the second role of a man. So she said, Africa is a man's world, and cinema in Africa is also a man's world. And women are not always really valued. So it's difficult, she said to us, to get attention and to be in the picture as a female actress. That was the message we got from her in 1989. So she was not alone. We had a lot of actresses and even male actors who said that, African male actors. And he said, it's good that you promote African cinema, but you promote a male African cinema, where we are always the female other. We are not valued in those films. Or we are second roles, or there's a problem in not every film, but in general. So you're reinforcing the female other. I said, what are we doing? We're doing working with African cinema, and then we're doing not the thing what should be done. So we were for a problem. So we asked us, what can African Film Festival do with the little means we have? Can we change the world with 5 euros? How to give actors and actresses in Africa African visibility, and that, in fact, how to humanize, making them familiar, familiar and known. That was our thing. So what can give visibility of a film festival? We have postcards, we have websites, catalogs. I'm not looking for the, I took it as random examples. You could put on a postcard a drum, a map of Africa, or something else. And most, 99% of all the posters about African Film Festival are such stereotypes. So our first post before we spoke with Mariam Kaba, it was, we wanted to do something with actors. We wanted to show the film and not something, let's say an African map with a camera on it and a woman and a man. So it's like the Portrait de Madeleine, one of the first women in France who was painted by a woman when slavery didn't exist anymore in France because the law were against after the revolution. She became one of the first individuals in art in France, and she was African. So we chose Mariam Kaba. We said we had a professional photographer. We were in Milan. We said, make a photograph and you choose your photograph. We don't want to know what, you choose your photograph. So she did it, and that became our concept. First we said we will take it as our logo, but that she said no, because there are other actresses, go for it. So she became in 1998, 1999, we took it again, and then we found Fatoumata Diouar, when she was not known. But there was a photo, we couldn't find it, we had found it from a film, but she agreed to it. And it was also in Louvain that she, for the first in her life, started singing for the public. Then we had Fatun Jai. She was very well known, and she also chose that photograph. She said, "I want to look to you." And we used it for our poster. That means we had 5,000 postcards. We had some 200-300 posters or 500. You can see it all everywhere in the city, and also all the websites. So that means the visibility is very. I think enormous. There are examples from what it means. Fifi Kigangari, you can always look. She has YouTube. She's a designer. She's played in one film, but she was a singer. And she chose that. She said, "I like to have something drama. I want." She did that. She is also very religious, but she is also a designer for the most richest people for Africa today. One of the most militant persons was Nola Masamba. She, from the 10 photos, she chose that photo. We were very astonished. We said, "Why are you doing that?" She said, "I like to do that. That's my photo." And then for the first time, we asked a professional photographer, Chris De Witte. He is one of the most famous, worldwide famous photographers for making photographs of film stars. He makes Clooney and other people. So we asked him to photo, and he stays always 2-3 days with the person before he gives us the photo. He make Aisha Maiga, and it's Aisha Maiga who took the heart. He said, "I was very astonished that she went to a flower. There was a flower pot with a heart in it. She took it and said, make a photo." So it's she who chose it. But you have to look the eyes. You will see the eyes. Look to the eyes. Then you see, discover the secret of the photographer. Then, of course, they say, "You always take women." So we had a lot of people saying, "Women, women, women." So we took Alex Discas and Mata Gabin, very famous people. So in France and the French-speaking world. So, but then we had a big critic. Why is the man above the woman? So we had they were attacking us violently. So we said, but they choose, they said, they choose, and they gave us a photo. And Mata Gabin is not, and she knows what she wants. And then we choose, you see, we put them aside. But then, of course, then we had other new photographs, and then we see it suddenly, we had younger people, coming film stars, and they wanted to have, not static, they said we want to have more movement. So we got those photographs. Ruth Nyerere, she's from, Rwanda or Burundi, she's a very famous singer, and also plays also roles in films. And Mariam Dandjais is also very known for the film Ezra. Then you see the eyes, always look into the eyes. Vanessa Ngonga, she's from Burundi, I believe, and she made our 20 years because that was a statement. Then we had Essa Lawson from the United States. She had a very beautiful film, and she lives also. And we were very upset, we as festival, when she gave the photo, because she had static photos, very, for us, normal photos, but she wanted that photo. So we found it very, we as festival, but she said, "It's my photo and I like to have the photo." Well, so she chose that photo. Then of course she said, "Why always women? Not why not a young, nice boy?" And that's the women who asked that. So we went to find Duke Koma, and he did it, what he did. It was not us. We wanted to have it. Chris De Witte stayed with him 3 days, and the result was that. He had made about 100 photos, and he chose that photo. So then we went more traditional, and all were more classical, and they, you see, Tatiana Rock and Rainer Campbell, they choose those photographs, but you always look to the eyes. You see, that's and that's Batida Sajo. She is a Belgian from Guinea-Bissau, very known in the French-speaking world and also in the English-speaking world. She makes even films in Iceland, but nobody knows her. Then that's Eric Ibonen, he played Lumumba in the film. So people, when he was walking the street, they thought they were seeing Lumumba. But he chose his classical film. Also the eyes are very important, always the eyes open, looking to the people. And then Mariam Al-Ferjani from Tunisia, we chose, but we had 2-3 photographs, sometimes very, for us, annoying, not annoying, but not easy for the grass, because it was sometimes she said she was a cat and not a cat with animals, so it was for us not easy to choose, because you don't never know how what you represent, what you will tell us what you represent. Now this year is another photographer, and those who know the film Rafiki knows that there's another way of looking. It's also a photo made by Chris De Witte. So it's made in Cannes, at the Cannes Film Festival, so it's also saying something about us, but also for about the film festival. What is up to you to fight? So, but in fact, we are doing also more substantive reflections, and that's yet since with Manon, she started to make a number of workshops with African women, the new diaspora, the new generation, and thinking about reflection about women and the confrontation with the body. So she had several workshops, she can tell more about it. So it was this third time, 3 years she did it, also on female sexuality. So it is a concern from us that we are looking on what we represent. And then last year it was We Are Womanists, where it was a fantastic year, I think, to promote and to do an issue on that. So it's thinking about how women, African women, are represented in our festival, because we have also to think about that. So that was the introduction.